हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर एनएफ जाधव वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल इनटू द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन ऑफ केमिस्ट्री सब्जेक्ट। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर और प्रीवियस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन ऑन केमिकल बॉन्डिंग एंड कैटालिसिस चैप्टर। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल गोइंग टू प्रोसीड ए नेक्स्ट पार्ट और सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन। In our previous part, we are discussed 20 questions, and after that, from 21 to 40 questions, we will going to discuss in this video lecture. So let us see the first question.
Before going to first question, once again, I would like to welcome all the students for the question answer session part 2 on a chemical bonding and catalysis chapter. Dear friends, in our previous lecture, we are going to discuss a 20 questions on chemical bonding chapter. In part 2 or in this video, we will discuss questions on chemical bonding and catalysis chapter also. So let us start first question. Just read a first question present on your screen. Metals are having good conductivity because of dash dash. And options are protons, option B neutron, option C localized electrons, and option D is none of the above. Friends, we know that the metals are good conductivity of heat and electricity, and the reason behind that, the electrons which are present in a metal, they are able to bonding, and due to that reason they are having good conductivity of heat and electricity. And the bonding electrons are nothing but it is a localized electron. Therefore, the answer of this question is C, localized electron. Now the second question present on your screen. Ionic compounds are soluble in a dash dash liquid, and options are water, benzene, kerosene, and acetone. Friends, this question is related to the electrovalent compound or ionic compound, and we know that when we are going to studying characteristics or properties of electrovalent compound, at that time the first property of this type of compound is miscibility or solubility, and such a kind of ionic compounds are soluble in water. Therefore, the option A is correct. Now let us see third question. Covalent compounds are insoluble in a liquid, and that liquid is dash dash. See the options: benzene, water, carbon tetrachloride, and acetone. We know that covalent compounds are present in non-polar form, and such a kind of non-polar form compounds are always insoluble in polar solvent. And here in the option, a second option is water, and water is present in a polar solvent. Therefore, the answer of this question is nothing but option B, water. Question number 4. Compounds formed by ionic compounds are dash dash conductor of electricity, and option A is good, option B bad, option C poor, and option D none of the above. We know that the ionic bond is present in electrovalent compound, and due to such a kind of property, they are able to conduct electricity. Therefore, the compound formed by ionic bond is a good conductor of electricity. So the correct option of the or answer of this question is option A, good. Question number 5. When covalent compounds are dissolved in solvent, then it produces dash dash. Before going to read options, we know that covalent compounds are insoluble in polar solvent. Therefore, it cannot produce any kind of ions. Hence, in these 4 options, a second option is present, no formation of ions. Therefore, the option B is correct. Question number 6. When the bond formed between atoms of elements, then it achieves dash dash. Option A, stable electronic configuration of noble gases. Option B, further reaction. Option C, avoid reaction. And option D is none of the above. We know that when the bond formation will be take place, at that time such a kind of atom of an element achieve a stable electronic configuration of noble gases. Therefore, the option A is correct for the question number 6. Now question number 7 on a concept of unit cell, that is a regular arrangement in which atoms are closely packed is called as dash dash. It is one of the definition present in first chapter, and the options are: option A is dipole structure, option B is tetrahedral structure, option C is lattice, and option D is none of these. We know that this is the definition of lattice, therefore a C option is correct. Question number 8, unit cell is the smallest unit of dash dash. Option A is liquids, option B is gases, option C is crystal lattice, and option D is all of the above. We know that a combination or small units of unit cell is nothing but crystal lattice. Therefore, option C is correct. Now let us see question number 9. Below the following dash dash is a crystal solid. Option A is glass, B is rubber, C plastic, and D sodium chloride. This is a very simple example of crystal solid or crystalline solid is nothing but glass, and this concept is nothing but a distinguish between crystalline solid and amorphous solid. Now question number 10 is again on distinguish between amorphous solid and crystalline solid. Same like question number 9, the same fashion will again repeat in question number 10. Select the correct example of amorphous solid, and the options are sugar, diamond, glass, and sodium chloride. We know that the option glass is the best example of amorphous solid. Therefore, option C, glass, is correct. Now, question is on crystal lattice concept. 11 number, magnesium and zinc has dash dash crystal lattice. Options are option A, simple cubic structure, option B, body center cubic structure, option C, face center cubic structure, and option D, hexagonal close packed structure. We know that this is an example of hexagonal closed packed structure. Therefore, option D is correct. Now from this question, the question starts on catalysis. Number 12, substance which either increase or decrease rate of chemical reaction without any change. We know that this is one of the definition of catalyst. Therefore, the option A, catalyst, is right. Question number 13 on classification of catalyst. Just read a question. When the reactant and catalyst are present in same phase, then it is called as dash dash. We know that if the reactant and catalyst are present in same phase, then we are going to call as it is homogeneous, and if it is present in different, then we are going to call as heterogeneous. Not autocatalysis or not heterogeneous catalysis. Therefore, for this question, when the reactant and catalyst are present in same phase, then it is called as homogeneous catalysis. In these options, second option is homogeneous catalysis. Therefore, option B is correct. Now again, question on classification. This question is again same like a question number 13, but just a little changes will be take place in this sentence. When the reactants and catalysts are present in different phase, means different phase means heterogeneous. Therefore, the option A is heterogeneous catalysis.
hence it is correct.
Now question number 15, the substance which inhibits the catalytic activity to accelerate a reaction rate called as dash dash. This is one of the definition present in catalysis subtopic. Options are catalytic promoter means catalytic activator, option B is catalytic inhibitor, option C is reactant in reaction, and option D is none of the above. We know that this is a definition of catalytic inhibitor, therefore option B is right for this question. Question number 16, the function of positive catalyst is dash dash. Option A is accelerate rate of chemical reaction, option B retard rate of chemical reaction, option C both A and B, and option D none of the above. We know that the positive catalyst increased a rate of chemical reaction, therefore a first option is correct. Now question number 17 is again on classification of catalyst. Just read question. The catalyst which decreases rate of any chemical reaction, then such a kind of catalyst is called as dash dash. Here the word decrease rate of chemical reaction is very important. We know that when the rate increase, we are going to use the positive catalyst, and if the rate is decrease, then we are going to use a negative catalyst. Therefore in all these four options, option A is negative catalyst, hence this option is correct. Dear students, sometimes may be questions asked on industrial applications of catalyst. So you should also prepare this concept. We know that in case of industrial applications, 8 to 9 different applications are present. In that applications, like how the different types of chemicals prepare, how the different types of processes runs, and which a different type of catalyst will be used on that particular process. For example, we know that the ammonia is manufactured by using nitrogen and hydrogen, and in this process we are use iron as a catalyst and molybdenum as a promoter, and the whole process is developed or demonstrated at first a scientist Haber's, therefore we are going to call it as Haber process. Such a kind of questions are again asked in your MSBT exam, like contact process. We know that by using contact process we are going to manufacture sulfuric acid, and during a manufacturing of sulfuric acid we use a catalyst like a platinum. Hence such a kind of questions are maybe asked in your MSBT exam. So just prepare all the concepts present in chemical bonding and catalysis chapter. This is a very simple and basic chapter. Therefore, the maximum marks you will achieve from this chapter. Hence, you are prepared very well. So this is all about a second part of question answer session discussion on chemical bonding and catalysis chapter. I hope you will enjoy these two sessions. So at the end of this lecture, I would like to thank all of you. Thank you. Thank you very much.